Hello, I'm Jamie and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about the fourth episode of series 5 of Ghosts, which was called En Francais. And this one I thoroughly enjoyed. I thought it was quite emotional and also very funny at the same time. There were a couple of main plot lines throughout this episode. One was the ghosts being like bored with their games that they were playing and were getting quite scared about, you know, facing eternity as a ghost. We had Alison and Mike trying to impress the person that was interested in turning their land into a golf course. And then we had the revelation that Robin knows how to speak French and learnt it by observing Humphrey's wife, Sophie, and her maid like talking to each other, which I thought was really, really sweet. That's what I'm going to talk about first, I think, because I thoroughly enjoyed this. I really like that we've got more Humphrey in this season. I think he's such an interesting character. And like we had in the first episode, we had kind of Humphrey talking about how he's sick of kind of being taken for a joke. And I think this episode really draws on that and just shows how like human he is, how like, you know, his imperfections, like this conscience that he's got throughout, you know, he's kind of feeling guilty about the way he treated his wife. And like, you know, he's talking about his regrets and stuff. And I thought it was a really, really sweet and emotional episode. And it started with the fact that we learned that Robin can speak French really, really well, which is quite shocking in a way. But in another way, I'm also not too surprised because we've talked about it before, about how he is like the most intelligent out of the group because he's observed people throughout history and is able to pick up on lots of different things. And the fact that he can speak it so well, better than like his native language, is a bit surprising. But I think it was obviously drawn from that loneliness and having these two people and being entertained by these two people that are talking in a different language, and that he's able to pick up and learn from it, which I thought was really, really cool and like really interesting and really sweet. I thought the first bit where we saw William move on, which was the bit that I did say looked a bit old to be a ghost moving on from like modern times. So yeah, I'm quite happy it wasn't a ghost moving on. But there, this was talking about William, which is one of the ghosts who he had been with for a long time. And yeah, he eventually moved on again. It seemed a bit sudden, which is why, you know, I feel like we've kind of had that with Mary. Mary felt a bit sudden as well. And then Robin is left to be alone again, and for seemingly quite a long time until Humphrey and Sophie move into the house. I think having it showing like Humphrey and Sophie like being so young just again kind of emphasizes what a difficult position they were both put into, that, you know, they couldn't speak the same language and they were like very, very young and they were forced to be married and move in together, and that must have been really daunting and really scary. And I think that it was very difficult for both of them in like completely different ways. Sophie feeling just so isolated because she was in a different country, her religion was being persecuted, she only had one person to really talk to. And then Humphrey as well, I think just his awkwardness and perhaps kind of like feeling of guilt because of marrying her and uprooting her, like even though it wasn't his choice, I feel like we kind of get that sense of being guilty. And I just feel like he is just a bit awkward and doesn't really know what to do, and that then puts him in a difficult position because he can't talk to his wife, and they've got like this kind of like loveless, I mean, they're not even a relationship, they're, you know, they've been forced together. Thought his awkwardness was quite funny when he was trying to talk to her. You're like a bit, you know, it's like sad funny, but I thought that was I quite enjoyed that. I was a bit surprised at first about why Humphrey was jealous that Robin was able to speak French, because obviously he wasn't able to actually talk to Sophie. Sophie wasn't talking to him, like, you know, she didn't know he was there. So I was a bit, and like, I didn't really know why he was jealous, but it's obviously just come from that feeling of insecurity that he never learned to speak French, and also feeling of guilt that he never was able to either. And I think they had some really nice moments, and I think this again, it kind of draws into the first episode where Humphrey was really like desperate to prank Robin. I don't really know why, but it was nice to see them bond, which is I quite enjoyed that. And I think Robin was again quite smart and observant, and he was like, you talk but you don't listen. That's why nothing worked with Sophie. That's why you're in the situation. That's why you never learned how to talk, how to speak French, because you never listened, or you can never see what was truly happening. Yeah, I thought that was really good. And again, you know, very emotional, and Humphrey willing to be a bit vulnerable and acknowledge that, and then try to learn and have Robin teach him some French. And this obviously links to the other plotline that we have with Alison and Mike trying to impress the golf lady, with when she is like really suffering from a allergic reaction, that Robin thinks that this is a good learning moment for Humphrey to try and translate what she is saying while she is like almost dying, which was just hilarious. I was like, I thought for a second we might have another ghost, but I thought that might, like, I didn't really think it seriously. It was a bit like, it was just a thought that kind of popped in my head. I feel like it would have been way too difficult for like Alison and Mike if that did happen. But yeah, I just thought all of that bit was just, it was emotional and funny. It was just, it was really sweet. It was nice to see Humphrey like involved more seriously in, like in an episode, not just there as a joke. Cause even though he kind of was involved more in the first episode, he still was just kind of there as like a way to fuel Alison's mischief. Whereas this, it's, you know, a genuinely emotional moment for him. And then of course the last little bit we got was that Robin can speak Russian as well, which I think it poses a lot of questions, like who was Russian that was living in a Button house? Like, could it be like a spy of some sort? I don't know, there's lots of questions that could come from that, which I think is quite fun. I don't think we're gonna get any answers, but I like that. I thought that was a nice little touch. I wonder how many other languages he can speak. So yes, on to Alison and Mike and the golf course. I did like that Mike tried to speak French. I know he obviously wasn't very good, and you know, it was only a few hours of practice, but I think the gesture was nice, especially since we've got that paralleled with Humphrey, who's married to somebody French and hasn't really bothered to learn the language, and he's just meeting somebody for the first time and has tried to learn some things to say, which I think is quite nice. And I do think his members bar is a good idea. I think it was really like it was a really smart idea. It sets them up for the rest of their lives. I thought he was being really smart about all this kind of thing. I've seen some people that really disliked Mike in this episode, but I think both Alison and Mike were right to some degree. I think Alison was right to just be like, just focus on this bit. We'll get this bit over with. And then we'll deal with everything else later. But then I think Mike was quite smart with the fact that, like, you know, the effort to go in, like, you know, making that effort to speak French, and, you know, the idea of this members bar could be a selling point. So I do think they were right in their own ways, and I can understand why they did clash. I thought their clashing was quite funny. I think this was really funny, and I like that they eventually bonded on the, like, how annoying the translator was, because Alison did seem to be getting quite frustrated with the translator, no, with Mike's frustration about the translator. But because, yeah, he just kept translating things too much, translating the wrong things. He was translating every single word, which was not helpful. And so I can understand why, like, yeah, that might get Alison to get annoyed. But yeah, I like that they eventually bonded, and using Robin to translate what he was saying to get ahead of him and to win the deal with the golf course lady. Sabine. So yeah, trying to get ahead of that and win the deal with Sabine. And almost killing her in the process, which was quite funny. I think they set it up very well with Alison, like, you know, Mike feeding him the tea and getting him, like, so desperate to go to the toilet so he can then move in and try and win the deal. And then, like, her almost dying without access to a translator. I thought it was set up really, really well. I thought it was very entertaining and very fun. I think the funniest part came from the ghosts themselves, them trying to figure out new games to play and eventually settling on doing TV game shows to entertain themselves. I thought that this was so good. I loved all the games that they played. Blankety blank, I loved that the captain did not understand what he was supposed to do at all. Didn't understand how the game rules. How the game worked. I did think the blank pun was quite funny though. I did quite enjoy that. There are lots of different things that came up in this. You know, the idea that they're struggling to find a game that works for everybody because everybody has like an objection to certain things or don't understand. You know, Kitty not liking the game that she got like the question wrong to, and Fanny being against double entendres within the blankety blank game, which is quite funny considering she has the most double entendres in the whole and the whole show. So I loved that. That was I thought that was very funny. I wish they had tried to play pointless. I loved Thomas's insistence on the game that he wanted to get the most points. There was so much good stuff in this. You could probably watch it each time and find something new that was funny every single time you watched it. And I like that they settled on playing Mastermind, but asking Alison all the questions. Just funny seeing Alison sitting on the chair, just spouting off random words that had no connection to each other that the translator was seeing. But yeah, I loved all, like, Pat's especially, like, his role as the host of the game shows. I thought that was really good. And the captain as well, his like announcement was really good. Again, he didn't understand what he was doing, but I thought that was great. Doing the theme tune with Robin going in with like the song as well, it is all very funny. And then Ben coming full circle and creating your dream hamper, which is the same thing that they've been playing the whole time. It's just food club and then the other game that Pat was trying to do, like the last meal you ever eat. And I love that that came with the implication that both Robin and Julian have killed people. Robin, not surprised by. Julian, I'm a little bit surprised by. Even though he's morally bankrupt, I wouldn't have quite put him at, you know, to that kind of level. But I think one of the funniest little bits that we had was when Pat proposed the game of the last... what would your last meal be? And then pointing it out that it was just food club. And the way he kind of like held his shorts up and was like, his facial reactions, just that whole little bit was so funny. Like, it cracks me up every time I see it. It was so good. Overall, this episode was really, really strong. I really, really enjoyed every second. I thought it was so hilarious with the game show and, you know, with the translator getting things wrong, but then quite emotional with Humphrey and his little backstory, and with Robin again, with his feeling of loneliness, because I think it's something that's been touched on throughout the series. And I thought, I always feel so bad for him because it must be so, so difficult in the way he's able to make the most of it. All the other ghosts being a bit scared about what their future is because they have to live with each other for forever unless they move on. So I thought it really like put it into perspective for them, and again just shows how long Robin has been there and how much he's able to learn from everybody else. I think that I'm a little bit surprised that Humphrey didn't, like, there wasn't a hint that Humphrey would move on, because he did kind of have a revelation a little bit, like he came to terms with something, he apologized to Sophie. I think that was a really nice moment, so I am surprised that they didn't at least like tease him getting moved off a little bit, because it definitely, I was a little bit like, oh, is it gonna happen? And then the episode just kind of ended. I was a little bit shocked that he didn't, but I thought it was a really, really nice episode. I think it encapsulates everything that we like about Ghosts. And it was so good. If you like this video, then please leave a like. It really helps the channel. And comment down below your thoughts on episode 4 of Ghosts. Again, no spoilers about future episodes, just in case people are watching them week by week. And subscribe if you want to see more videos to do with Ghosts. I'll have some more out for you soon. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.